Demo 2. It's one of the most highly anticipated launches in SpaceX's career, mostly because if all goes to plan, it'll be the first private spacecraft to carry humans to low Earth orbit. Back in 2014, SpaceX was chosen and given $2.6 billion as part of NASA's Commercial Crew contract, a deal that would help NASA garner its independence from Russia and reestablish the United States as a contender in crewed spaceflight. But there's been some delays, financially and technically, that have prevented the SpaceX team in getting the Crew Dragon capsule ready for launch. They did have a successful unmanned demonstration mission, Demo 1, in March 2019, showing off their capsule's capabilities to go to the ISS and back. But they notoriously lost that first Crew Dragon in a following static fire test in April. As it turns out, rocket science is hard. But the team has been steadfast in a multitude of tests to improve the capsule since. Now, we're just around the corner from viewing the company's final milestone before a crewed demo, the in-flight abort test. It will be the determining factor in how soon SpaceX can get astronauts off the ground and into space. Most of these final tests are extra safety demonstrations SpaceX wants to take to showcase the functionality of the spacecraft during abort ascent, ensuring the security of the astronauts on board, meaning the parachutes, backup engines, and controls are all in working order. Now, in past months, NASA did express concern over parachute systems based on previous tests where the spacecraft hit the ground harder than it should have and sustained damage. And dang, did SpaceX take that note seriously? At the end of October through November, the company completed an unprecedented 12 consecutive and successful parachute drop tests in a single week, starting with one chute test with their new Mark III design and then moving on to a multi-chute one. This particular drop test used 3 parachutes instead of the standard 4 to see how the capsule would fare just in case one blew out. Working with supplier Airborne Systems, SpaceX improved these Mark III parachutes by integrating Xylon, a high-performance polymer material that's lightweight and known for its strength. Elon Musk even suggests that the parachutes are possibly 10 times safer than the Mark II versions. The team is continuing to improve the quality of their design, but they earn their spot to the next stage, the static fire test. To start, the crew capsule is equipped with 2 distinct propulsion systems, one composed of 16 Draco thrusters for on-orbit maneuvering and 8 backup Super Draco thrusters for use only in the event of a launch escape. A static fire test is when the rocket engine is strapped to the ground and ignited. Engineers can then observe how these thrusters would work during flight, as well as showcase that they operate smoothly. This is where things went not so smooth in April. A faulty valve let a liquid oxidizer leak into the high-pressure tubes, and milliseconds into the Super Draco thruster's ignition, an explosive chain reaction occurred, completely destroying the Crew Dragon. This was a heavy loss for the team, since that particular capsule had just successfully flown, uncrewed, to the ISS and back. But although they're starting from scratch, SpaceX and NASA considers the anomaly good testing. It was in a controlled setting, no one was hurt, and they can improve these backup thrusters. The newest version has implemented burst disks that prevent a leakage from happening again. The latest test happened in November 2019, and it was a success, bringing us to the highly anticipated in-flight abort test. Now, what should we expect when it happens? Since the in-flight abort is a simulation of the worst-case scenario, it'll look a little like this. The Crew Dragon will sit atop a Falcon 9 rocket and launch into the air for almost a minute, just like in a typical launch. Then, after surpassing the speed of sound, the Merlin engines will turn off, a feature pre-programmed before launch. The computer onboard the Crew Dragon should detect the loss of thrust and trigger the escape system, aka the abort system. And this is where the previous parachute and static fire evaluations will come into play. The Super Draco thrusters ignite, pushing the Crew Dragon half a mile away in just 7.5 seconds, reaching a peak of 436 miles per hour, then deploying its parachutes for a safe touchdown. With every test, SpaceX comes one step closer to bringing crews onboard its capsule. If the in-flight abort test goes well, the team can plan to have its first manned mission in early 2020. And this is a big deal, not only for commercial spaceflight, but for everyone. It opens the door to the endless possibilities that we can achieve. Engineering that can get us outside Earth's atmosphere, to the moon, to Mars, and maybe even beyond. If you like this episode, make sure to subscribe and check out our Countdown to Launch playlist where you can catch up on all your rocket launch news. Are there any other rocket launches you'd like us to cover? Let us know down in the comments below. Thanks for watching.